Hello students, welcome to the lesson on chairs and keys. So in this lesson, we'll study about what are chairs, what are keys, what are the functions, and what are the different types of keys available, and how do we fix this chairs and keys to our tracks. Okay, so to get started with, let us first see what is a chair and its function. So this is nothing but the device which is used to hold the double headed or the bull headed rail in the required position. Now already we have seen about bearing plates in the last class, right? So bearing plates are nothing but chairs, but those are suitable only for the flat footed rail. So if you are going for a double headed rail or a bull headed rail, you have to go for a thing called as chair. So this is how your chair will look. Okay, so what is it? It is a device which is used for holding the double headed or TH, you can call it as, and bull headed BH rails in position. Okay, normally these are made up of cast iron. So your chairs are made up of the material cast iron. Now it has two jaws. Okay, so this is one jaw and this is another jaw. So it has two jaws and a rail seat. So this is called as what? Rail seat. So the jaw of the chair towards the inside of the track is called as inner jaw. In this case, this is your inner jaw and this is your outer jaw. Inside of the track, it's called inner jaw, and outside it is called as the outer jaw. And normally this rail seat is provided with a slope of 1:20 so that a tilt is provided to your rail. So directly the rail will not be having a tilt, but this chair will be having a tilt so that it will automatically have a, so that will in turn allow the rail to tilt, have a tilt of 1:20 inward. Okay, now normally this cast iron chairs will be weighing around 20.4 kgs. okay, so this cast iron chairs will weigh so much. Normally there are two types of cast iron rail chairs commonly used in practice. One is with the wooden key and the other one is with the Stewart's key. So when I discuss more about keys, I will explain in detail about this. Okay, so now whenever you want to fix this chair, if you are fixing it with wooden sleepers, you have to use 2 to 4 round spikes. Round spikes are nothing but some kind of fastenings which you use. So about spikes in more detail we'll study in the next lesson. So if you are fixing a chair to a wooden sleeper, then you have to use 2 to 4 round spikes. If you are fixing it for a cast iron sleeper, then you have to just cast it. Cast it is fix it or make this chair inbuilt when you are building your cast iron sleepers. And if you are using it with steel sleepers, if you are using it with steel sleepers, then you need to weld it. So normally we fix this chair with the
sleepers. If the rails are like this and the sleepers are like this, now we will fix the rails here like this so that the gauge is maintained and the sleepers are also in position. So this is all about the chairs. Now let us look into the functions of the chairs. There are majorly two functions that the chair has to perform. So 1 and 2. One is the bull headed or the rail has to be kept in position
in the track. That is the one main criteria. And the second criteria is that it has to distribute the load. So there is a huge load which is coming onto the rail, right? So what these chairs has to do is that whatever load is coming onto the rail, that has to be widely spread onto your sleepers. So that is also one of the function of your chair. So that's all about the chair. Now moving ahead to see what are keys. Now you observe in this figure, so this is a chair portion, right? If you observe, so this is your chair portion. We have seen here how the chair will look, right? So this is a chair portion. Here also, this is your chair portion, right? Now, in order to fix this chair to the rail, we either weld it, cast it, or we use spikes or chair bolts like this. Now, in between your rail and chair, you need some fastening. This is called as what? Your key. So this here, let me change the color. So this here in this shape, this is your key. Okay, here if you observe, see, this is your key. This particular thing is your key. Here, see, this is your chair, this portion is your key, and this is your rail. Here you have your sleeper. Sleeper, chair, rail, and this is your key. Now, what is a key? It is a small tapered piece of timber or steel. So, normally this will be made of timber or steel, which is used to fix rail to the chair. So, if you want to write the actual definition of key is what? Small tapered pieces of timber or steel used to fix rails to chair. So if you want to fix rails to the chair, you will use small pieces of timbers or steel. So this rails and chairs will have to be fixed on the metal sleepers. And also, for connecting your rails to bearing plates and steel sleepers. So this is the actual definition of your key. Now, various keys and cotters are being used in the Indian Railways for different rail connections. Now, in order to see what are the different keys available to us or types of keys, so we basically have two types of keys. The first one is your wooden key, so which is made up of the wooden material, and the second one is your metal keys. So metal keys are again further classified two categories. So one is the Stewart's key and the other one is called as your Morgan key. Right. Now when it comes to the wooden key, they are nothing but your straight tapered pieces of timber. So this is your key. Here if you observe this red portion, whatever we have marked, that is your wooden key. Okay, these will be in what shape? Tapered shape, and these are the pieces of timber. Now why we use these? These are very cheap and can be easily prepared, but the problem is they are likely to be stolen and they are subjected to what they are subjected to be attacked by your white ants or vermins, through which they will not have their proper structure intact. Understood. And also disadvantage of using this type of keys are that they are not very strong, and there are also chances that they will get loosen under the vibrations. So what will happen frequently, you have to tighten it, and it involves more maintenance. So that's the reason wooden keys are not much used in Indian railways especially. So what are all the things about wooden keys? These are cheap, agreed, right? They are tapered in position, but they are not much used because of the problem that they can be stolen easily and they can be attacked by your vermins and white ants. Also, there are chances that they get loosened and not very strong. So because they get loosened, what will happen? The maintenance cost is very much high. Understood? So in order to overcome these disadvantages of the wooden key, we go for what? Metal keys. So let's see in depth about metal keys. Again, these are either like a form of small tapered pieces or spring type pieces. So similar to wooden keys also, we will have metal keys, or they will be in the form of a spring like this. So this is a spring key. This is made up of what? Your metal. Understood? Now these metal keys, initial cost of this metal keys is high, but because they are strong and durable and their life is also 10 times more than your wooden keys, using this will be very feasible. So they are your strongest and durable keys. Also, these keys will not get loosened quickly, and frequent tightening is not required. So what will happen? The maintenance cost is less when compared to the wooden keys. So normally what will happen? Over the wooden keys, metal keys are more used. Now, as I told you, there are two types of metal keys. One is the Stewart's key and the other one is the Morgan key. Now we'll see what is the difference between the Stewart's key and the Morgan key. Now Stewart's key is made up of what? It is a steel plate which is bent in the form of a spring. So if it is in this manner, then it is called as what? Your Stewart's key. Okay, so this particular type is called as your Stewart's key. This is bent in the form of a spring. It will resemble your letter E. If you see it in the reverse way, it will resemble your letter E. And what will happen? There will be a small place here. If you observe, there is a small place which is left open. Now this is the space for a steel wedge so that it fits properly in the position. So this is how your Stewart's key will look, right? When it comes to Morgan key, now this is named Morgan because it is patented by a person called as Morgan. This key is nothing but it will be similar to your wooden key, but it will be made up of steel. So it will be tapered. Normally it will be of 180 mm long and it will be tapered in 1:32, like a steel wedge. So like this, if you want to say something like this, it will look. So it will be tapered like this in 1:32. So if it is in the form of a spring or a letter E, then it's called a Stewart's key. And if it is in the form of a tapering steel wedge, then it is called as Morgan's key. The name Morgan's key is given because it is patented by a scientist called as Morgan. Now these keys are usually used for what? Connecting your rails to your cast iron chairs, plate sleepers, or your steel sleepers. Generally what will happen, you will need two keys. You will need how many keys? Two keys are required for each link of steel sleepers with the rail. So in order to connect each link, we need two sleepers. Now out of all the keys, that is the wooden keys and in case of the metal keys, the Stewart's key and Morgan key, this is the best one because it has three major advantages. So it has three major advantages. The first one is that you can use a particular type, whether it is in the left hand portion of the sleeper or in the right hand portion of the sleeper, you can use it anyway. Now this will, what will happen it, in case of Stewart's key, it is not like that. For left hand you have to use separately manufactured one, and for right hand you have to use the separately manufactured one. But here same piece can be used either in the left hand side or the right hand side of the connection. Okay, that is one advantage. The second advantage is that it is of lightweight. So the second advantage is what? It is of lightweight. And the third advantage is it can be used in various places, like for cast iron chairs, as I told, for plate sleepers, for steel sleepers. So for all these things you can use, multi-use it can be done. So that's the reason Morgan keys are majorly used keys. So this is all about your types of keys and the chairs and its function. Now how they fix this chairs to the key, this is the same figure. So this is the same figure. So on the inner side we put the rail, on the outer side we put the key, and then tighten it between the jaws so that this rail will not get displaced. Okay, so this is how you will be fixing your chairs with the keys onto your what? Rail, and then this chair in turn will be placed on the sleeper. This is all about your chairs and keys. Hope you understood. Thank you.